Hey everybody, Monica here. So I was starting to put this card together and I decided, why not record it? My kids are outside playing with their dad and the neighbors. So this is a perfect time to record the process video while I'm going because no kids will be interrupting. Okay, so I've already started. I decided to use Recollections card base. I was originally gonna do a step card because I created one previously, which I will show at a later date. But then I decided, you know what, let's just go back to this. I have a lot of these types of cards ready to go where they're already matted with the designer paper and the cardstock. All I have to do is embellish. So this is a Recollections card base. It's 6.5 by 5. So I've already gone ahead and matted it. I've got a cream card base with black cardstock mat. Then this script paper on the top comes from a digital paper that I bought from Etsy. It's part of the Vintage Love Letters, I believe it's called. I will link the where I purchased the digital papers from in the description box below in case you're interested. So I've already matted the front. I've also matted the inside, and I've already put the corners on the inside. Now, for the time being, I'm only gonna have these two corners in here. I don't plan on putting anything on the bottom as of right now, but I could change my mind later. So I used the same paper on all three locations. I thought it was simple and it lets the metal shine through. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna start gluing the front together, and then I'll do the stamp sentiment, and then I'll place that on the inside once I am done. I have used my Spellbinders labels 5, and I used the largest die of all of them to cut out my label, and that is for the cream cardstock. For the black border, I just glued my mat down and then fussy cut all the way around it to get the thinner border because I don't like the space from one die to another, and I was using the largest die of the set here. Okay, so I've got a whole bunch of metal filigree pieces. Now, I'm going to do the design on the front like I did on a previous metal embellishment, something similar to this one, except I won't be using the butterfly. This will be a little bit tighter together. It won't be so long, and I'll be using a paper flower in the center. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and let's start with the corners. So as you know, glossy accents takes a little bit of time to dry. So I'm just gonna go ahead and, is my glossy accents clogged? Yes. And I was just using it, which is funny. I literally was just using this like not even 5 minutes ago. Let's open that back up. Anyways, now who knows what the heck I'm going, ooh, too much oozed out. What the heck I'm gonna talk about. So this is a piece that's going to be heavy on metal. As always, a lot of my stuff are. I do have another card that I'm working on, another layout that is not quite so heavy on the metal. So I'll also record a start to finish on that one. So with glossy accents, it does take a little while to adhere to the paper. So I just hold it down for a little bit until it starts grabbing its shape. And then I'll put something on top of it to hold it down for me while I'm sitting there gluing the other side, which in this case, I'm using one of my label punches from StampinUp while I start on the other side. And where's my other corner? Here we go. And I just have this all scattered around. Believe it or not, I feel like my desk is a disaster right now. And this, and these two things are all that I have on it. But I usually keep them in like nice, neat, stacked up piles of each piece. But I have, you know, as I was laying the design out on the paper, I just decided to just scoot it all off. Alrighty, anyways, so I have my corners down. I'm putting two of the larger filigree corners on opposite ends. Okay, this one should be down pretty good already, so let's move on to this side. Now I'm gonna go ahead and adhere my piece here. So typically what I do is before I glue them down, I lay the bottom piece down so I know roughly the area that where it's going to go, and then I just lift one piece at a time. That way I place it back in the proper spot. And this is just, you know, another birthday card that I'm creating for the stash. There's no particular reason for this card. I just, you know, since I sell my cards, I like to have a whole bunch ready to either sell or to use should the need arise. So like I said, I'm very generous with the glossy accents, as long as it doesn't start oozing out. Now I really like this paper. It's really simple. The paper does have like a peachy coral type color on it for the roses that you see here, but they're very, very pale, so I don't mind working with it. Now the sides and the script on it is all brown, but I didn't have a dark enough brown to use as my matte, so I just decided to just use black. It's pretty close. It wasn't too big of a deal. And it's sliding around like there's no glue on this thing, but there is. Now I'm gonna have to lay it right back down where I had it because it's gonna leave the watermark of the glossy accents. Shoot. Okay, let me go ahead and look. That looks pretty good there. Okay, now we'll do the bottom one. Eventually, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is not talk through these videos, and once I learn how to use iMovie, I will go ahead and just do this on fast play so you guys don't hear my blabbering. But since I'm doing this as I go, you don't really want to sit here in silence, so I might as well blab. So I create a lot of cards that are very similar in style, because I sell so many of them. I change up, you know, the colors, I change up the flowers, the way I arrange certain things. So, you know, typically when I'm selling stuff, I might create two or three of the same card, but in different colors. And people don't really care, they buy them anyway. I mean, it's no different than sitting there buying a Hallmark card where, you know, there's thousands of the same one going out to, you know, people. So I don't really mind it too much. Okay, that looks pretty good there. So I'm just gonna give it a good push down. Make sure it's sticking to the paper fairly well. And now we're using this fleur-de-lis, and that's gonna sit on top of this one. Now this will take a while to dry. So when you're doing this, definitely do not plan on moving your pieces at all. Just leave it flat, don't touch it, don't move it to another area. Just leave it be, because you are putting a lot of glossy accents down and it does take a long time to dry. Because metal adheres better when you're going metal to paper. When you're doing metal to metal, it definitely takes longer to dry. So definitely you want to put that into account when you're gluing your metal filigree or any kind of metal onto something that's not paper or chipboard or whatever the case might be. Metal to metal always takes longer. So, and when I'm blowing, I'm just blowing in the little, when I put a lot of glue in, sometimes the glue comes in through these holes. I just blow it on it to get the glue to not sit there. I'm gonna move that one around. Okay. So what I will do is, as I'm gluing all of this stuff down, I haven't quite decided what stamp I'm gonna use for my sentiment on the inside. So once I'm done gluing this stuff down, I'll pause the video and then I'll come back once it's dry to go ahead and stamp out my sentiment to place on the inside, because now that I'm putting this on here, since I didn't put my stamp mats on the inside, I have to wait for this to dry, because if I try to open it, it'll just slide off and fall off the metal pieces. The back piece is already down with the paper, but these pieces, the fleur-de-lis that I'm putting on, if I was to open my card off, they just slide right off. So you definitely want to wait. I'd probably come back maybe 45 minutes to an hour later. Okay. And you can probably hear that a car alarm going off outside. Kind of annoying. Okay. So there's that. Now that is on lightly, and as you can see, they are sliding around a little bit. Okay, so we're gonna add this doily on top, but first I want to add these flourishes. These flourishes come from the Spellbinders Venetian Motifs. It comes from that. So this is where I'm drawing in more of the black that I used on the cardstock on the outside. And since I have my glossy accents out, I'm just gonna use the glossy accents. I usually use like my Tombow Mono Multi. I'm trying to see where else. Or my Fabri-Tac to adhere these down. That looks pretty good there. And I'm not pushing them down because in case I wanna move it around once I get my doily in place, I can get it to move. So I'm barely tapping it down to the metal. So I know, like right there, I want this one to come out a little bit more. Oop, and it's moving my metal on the bottom. Okay. Yeah, that looks pretty good right there. So, and like I said, I got the glossy accents out, so I'm just gonna use it on the doily as well. Okay. So let's go ahead and put this down right in the center. So I'm either thinking that flower, I mean, I kind of covered up this rose here. So that flower brings color to the piece. I do have, if I can find it, let's see. I have another flower like it where I was goofing around with it and I threw alcohol ink on it because I couldn't find my bronze paint. So it did splotchy coloring of the flower. So I was originally planning on putting that one in. But as you can see, it tones it down a lot. So we can use this coral one. This is an extra flower. I had colored another one from a previous card. And I'll be right back. Alrighty, hey guys, I'm back. Sorry to cut you off. The honey came in the house and he comes in and he starts chatting. So I did just a little bit more just so you guys don't have to sit there and watch as I do it. So I stamped my sentiment onto my label, as well as my little happy birthday sentiment out in front. So this is good for now. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this up and adhere this, the mats, to the inside. That way any additional work that we have just goes out to the front, and then we don't have to open the card again for a while. Oh, I'm being really messy with this, so. Okay. Oh. My hands are dirty, I'm getting glue everywhere. Okay. So let's go ahead and center this as best we can. That looks pretty good there to me. I could be off. So I'm gonna go ahead and close it to push it down since we have this in the way. Let's go ahead and adhere this one as well. And I'm just using my ATG. I could use my Fabri-Tac, whatever you want. This is gonna be where the person giving the card is gonna stamp their sentiment. I mean, write their message, not stamp the sentiment. Okay. There we go, now we can close it. So I put dimensionals on top of my little label here. This is StampinUp Modern Label Punch. I've used Stampin' Up! Teeny Tiny Wishes stamp set on this. And I'm just gonna put this right here in the lower right hand corner. I'm just gonna take my flower and I'm just gonna use a nice dollop of Fabri-Tac, since this is going on top of the doily. Alrighty, so there's that. So now, just need to pick the bling that I want to go ahead and add to this. I mean, do I want to add any leaves? Let's see. I mean, I already got so much metal on it. Maybe it doesn't need leaves. Let's lift this up. Does it need a leaf? I'm lifting it up to see really closely. Ah, what the heck, let's leave the leaves there. So lift that up real quick. Where's my glossy accents? And son of a gun, it clogged again. That's the one bad thing about glossy accents. It's always clogging. But I'm thinking about putting one of those fine tip nozzles on mine. Okay. Oh, my kids are in the house now. So probably ruckus is going to start pretty soon. I'm just sticking a little glossy accents there, since most of the flower is going to be down with Fabri-Tac. Okay, now we need a flower center. Okay, so we're using one of these. I'm just lifting up the petals to cup it a little bit more. Get some glossy accents on there. Cup it right in the center. And the flower's too high, so it's not gonna wanna stay. Okay, let's see, let's use a different center. One that we can manipulate a little bit more. On this one, it's just the petals are too high. Let's try this one. There we go. This one nestles in a lot better. Okay, now let's decide what color bling to put on this thing. Shall we use our Vitrail? Nope. Shall we use this one? Hold on 1 second, my hubby's calling me now. Alrighty, I'm back. Man, hubbies always interrupt. Okay, so I decided to go with the clear bling. It will stand out a little bit better against the background. I was originally gonna use a light Colorado topaz, but there's so much brown on here that it's going to blend in. The clear stands out a lot more. So as always, we're gonna put a drop in the center. And in the center of this one, we are going to put an SS20. And I'm using my trusty crystal katana because I love that thing. Right there. Then let's see, maybe some little pieces in the corner over here. Let's do, I got some SS8s out. SS8s look kind of small. We can put those actually in the corners. I'm gonna put them in the corners right here. So let's put some glue down. Ooh, and I better make this fast. I hear my kids just got in the shower. So I'm gonna have to go tend to them in a second. Okay. Oh, did I put enough glue down? Yes. And this is just the tedious part of putting the bling down. And I always put bling in these little sections of these corners. It's just perfect for it. So using the metal tip to go ahead and push my bling down, not the wax tip. Okay, where else does this card need bling? Let's see. Since we're going straight to paper now, I'm gonna go ahead and use my gem tack because glossy accents leaves that clear sheen gloss on everything, and I don't want that. So let's put, let me look at it here. Is my glue gonna come out? Nope. For this having a pin, it's not supposed to clog, and it's been clogging on me lately. And now it's making me mad because I can't get the glue to come out, and it's what I wanted to use, so forget it. We're using glossy accents. Okay. Let's use, should we put them on the corners? Oh yeah, let's put just a dollop here. And a dollop here. And we just want it to be small for this one. There, and is that the same size? Yes. And there. I'm trying to see where else we could put bling on here. I mean, we could probably put a lot of bling everywhere, but we can keep it simple and just leave it like that. Or how about on the corners? Let's see how three look in the corner. Yeah, let's do three in the corner on the upper and upper corner and lower corner. One, two, three. All right. Let's make this fast because this video is already extremely long. And I'm not using my mat here. Otherwise, I'd be able to flip the gems with my fingers a lot easier. Okay. One. Two. And three. Okay, let's put these back in the container. Alrighty, so my card is now done. There we go, if you can see everything. I hope you can see everything well. Oh, there we go, you can see a little bit better. I'm on my tippy toes, it's hard for me to see the view of the camera. Alrighty, so here is my completed card. Here's the front, here's the inside, and the back is stamped with my Handmade by Stamp Sentiment. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.